My name is Dagmar Kress. I am a flight instructor, mainly have been a flight instructor for 30 years. And since I live in Denver, this is now 15 years, I became a board member for the Wings Over the Rockies Museum. And I'm also a lecturer at the Metropolitan State University of Denver. And I'm the coach of the aerobatic team there. The start in aviation was a ride, and I was already older. I was actually here in the United States to study business administration. The plan was never for me to become a pilot. And I got a ride, and I learned how to fly, and about 5 years later, I switched to flying. And there were just people in the area that flew aerobatics, and I tried that, and I liked it, and I got into aerobatics. It came easier to me than flying straight and level, holding your head in. That's my niche. It turned out to be my niche. When you are able to be high up, up high, you can look down at the world, at the landscape, at the clouds, at the sky. For me, I have only two expressions, and I keep repeating those. It's freedom and peace. It connects people. It enables people to get to other countries that are far away, meet other people, meet other cultures, understand other cultures, bring the world together. It's also a transport of goods. Goods that have to be brought to other places quickly. Medicines, organs, organ transplants, things like that. So aviation provides a quick transport. Aside of the fact that as a pilot, it's a lot of fun. There are a lot of things one can do in aviation. Somebody has to design the plane. Somebody has to build it. Somebody has to maintain it. The planes are not maintained, they will fall apart and they will not be flight worthy. Somebody is an air traffic controller. There are also, if you want to go into administration of airports, airport managers, people who work in the offices, people who sell the fuel. Airplanes cannot fly without the support crew on the ground. There's an entire industry connected to aviation. If one goes from maybe taking an airline flight, you get on the airplane, you sit down in the seat, the airplane takes off rather shallow, maybe like this, and then it flies level, and the banks, the curves, the turns are smooth, and then you land again. Nothing special. This is the normal flight. And aerobatics, again, you pitch more than 30 degrees. So if you go up steep and vertical and over and do a loop, that's more than a 30 degree pitch that can be up or down. And the bank, when you lean more than 60 degrees, knife edge and invert it and you do a roll, that would be also considered aerobatic flight. It's cool. That's all I can say about it. And of course, you can just go out and have fun and fly a few rolls and loops, and that's very satisfying. There is then you can do it competitively. There are aerobatic competitions.
The airplane outlines a nearly perfect circle in the sky.
It's comparable to figure skating, where you have judges on the ground. They look at certain figures you have to fly, a given sequence, for example, of a looping and a roll and a hammerhead. And the loopings, for example, have to be perfectly round. So the judges look at that.
In performing the loop, here are the points of common error.
It's very difficult to fly around loops. They're usually like eggs or watermelons. They are not round on a normal basis. And then you get deductions. That would be the competitive side. And then, of course, there are air shows. Lots of people have seen air shows. And to fly aerobatics that low to the ground, you actually need to practice a lot to stay current, be able to fly these figures predictably and precisely low to the ground without crashing into the ground. Outside of air show flying, we fly much higher in aerobatics. We don't risk having any impact with the ground. So it's very safe, really. Aerobatic flying is very safe. The aerobatic airplanes are built stronger than normal airplanes to withstand those stresses of the G-forces, and we fly very high. when I've not been flying through the winter or so and I get back into it, I don't have that steel stomach. I get dizzy. I get sick. I took a little statistical sample. I think 97% of people get queasy after about half an hour. And that's normal because we do things in the airplane you cannot simulate on the ground. It's better to go home and land and wish you could have done more than to get really sick. And then you try it again about after the third flight, it's gone. The majority of aerobatic flying is really based on safety training. We do stalls, we do spins, we recover from these attitudes. It's good to have that so you can react better if you ever get into a distressful situation. I personally must say, I don't think aviation should be gender specific. Men can do that, women can do that, everybody can do that. It just happened so that in the past, not so many women did it, and maybe that has to do with the old distributions of the tasks.
Here's an American pilot off to practice acrobatics. Let's see what he must remember to do.
If you go 100 years back, 200 years back, the women were home bringing up the children, taking care of the house, and the men were the providers.
Mother, you promised to have dinner ready at 6 o'clock.
I'm sorry, Catherine. I just didn't finish my other work.
So there are certain professions that are probably not so easy for women. As a pilot, if you're an airline pilot, you are away a lot. So it's hard to have a family, and it takes planning and logistics. Lots of women manage to do that, but it takes planning. But I see this changing. Women can fly just as well as men. And when we fly the Young Eagles, which is a program also done by the Wings Over the Rockies Museum, and I'm one of those Young Eagle pilots. The Young Eagle program is a program to provide a free experience to children to fly and see what flight aerospace aviation is all about. It takes only one exposure for somebody to catch fire and say, hey, this is nice. I could see myself doing that. A lot of the young children who come are girls. I would say they're half of them are girls. And they are brought by their parents and their fathers especially, walk them up to the airplane and say goodbye to them and have a good flight. And I think this is so great. So times are changing. And for the girls, I can only say, if I can do it, you can do it. So I hope in aviation, we will still be able to fly as pilots because everything gets automated and that will drive the pilots out maybe. To make it more accessible, less expensive, use new energy sources. To make it available to the ones who want to fly to be able to do it. That's my hope. That's my dream. And then in a greater aspect that people are able to use aviation, as they do already, to travel around the world. It brings the world together. If you want to be philosophical, it brings peace to the world for people to meet each other and get along.